Thank you, Dr. Parikshit. At the outset, I would like to thank Dr. Gyan Prakash, Dr. Susan, for giving us an opportunity to present our telescreening project for ROP, the ROPE SOS, which was started with funding by USAID. Why we thought of a telescreening project for ROP? Because we all know that India has the highest number of premature births in the world. In the year 2005, the government of India, under its National Rural Health Mission, wanted to start a neonatal unit in all the district headquarters hospitals. And today, we have a little more than 700 government neonatal units to be operational in India. Moreover, apart from this, we have at least 5 to 15 in each of the districts which come under the private sector. So with all this improvement in neonatal care, many of these preterm babies survive even in rural areas, and this has led to an increase in the incidence of ROP. But the ground reality is the awareness of ROP is low, and although there are trained ROP screening experts, but they are available only in the urban areas and they are non-existent in the rural areas. Thus, there is a lacuna for providing ROP screening in these areas. So this led to the birth of ROPE SOS, which was a telescreening project and which was funded by USAID, which stands for United States Agency for International Development. When we started this, the aim of the project was to screen, we started it in the year 2015, and the aim was to screen 2,000 babies per year by doing ROP screening in the underserved and rural areas. And the team used to consist of two managers, two trained technicians, one mid-level ophthalmic assistant and a driver. And we covered neonatal units in 9 districts of our state of Tamil Nadu and neighboring state of Kerala. We targeted 200 kilometer radius from our base hospital at Coimbatore, covering Tamil Nadu and Kerala, and we had a memorandum of understanding with 53 neonatal units, including government hospitals. So in every week, we cover the two states of Tamil Nadu and Kerala, covering 9 districts, 18 towns, and 56 neonatal units. And the infrastructure used to consist of a red camp shuttle, and the technicians were trained in 2 phases, wherein in the first phase they were trained with using a red camp image practice kit, and in the second phase they were trained on babies under the supervision of a pediatric retina specialist. We also procured a van to carry the red camp machine and the diode laser machine, and the van had facilities wherein they can do a laser in the van itself. And the images that were captured were transferred using the modified address software for ROP, which was initially developed for diabetic retinopathy, but we modified it for ROP. And the connectivity was through broadband internet, which was very cost effective, and the central server was installed at the base hospital. We also used this opportunity to capture anti-segment images so that we could do a comprehensive eye screening. So as far as the continuum of care, the team will leave the base hospital in a van along with the red camp shuttle, go to the neonatal units. The ROP screening will be done using the red camp by the trained technician. And then the digital images will be loaded onto the and transferred to the base hospital, where the images will be graded by a ROP expert, and the report will be transmitted back to the neonatal units. If the child needs a laser, the laser will be done on the day by sending in a retina specialist or within 24 hours. Also, the most important thing is the advice is given to the family regarding the next follow-up, thereby doing a good counseling. So we started in the month of August 2015, and by January 2019, we had screened close to 17,224 babies, wherein 23%, that is 3,974, had some stage of ROP. 305 babies were treated, where 132 received intravitreal bevacizumab, 3 received intravitreal ranibizumab, and 167 babies received laser treatment. We also, in this program, developed multicolored ROP information posters and brochures which are given as handouts to all the parents. We also developed an SMS software where a periodic reminder is being sent to the parents, because I think the cell phone penetration today in India is close to 100%. So all the parents have access to a mobile phone, so we do send in a SMS. Also, in this, we had continuing medical education programs where we had sensitized 711 neonatal staff on the importance of ROP screening. We also sensitized them on the importance of using blenders, because many of these neonatal units were not using blenders. And after that, we had seen a drastic drop of aggressive posterior ROP from these neonatal units. This is one example of APROP, wherein the infant with a gestational age of 36 weeks at the birth weight of 1,800 grams, which would have normally fallen outside the NNF guidelines, but had developed an APROP. So the impact of this was more parents do demand eye evaluation of the newborn. And also, at the same time, more healthcare providers, the pediatricians especially, will refer the premature babies on time. And more ophthalmologists will be interested to get trained in ROP screening and management due to increased referrals and demand. This is just to show how the volume of in our pediatric retina unit increased over a course of time. We started a separate pediatric retina unit in the year 2011, and after that you can see the growth. And in the year 2015, we started the mobile screening, and we grew almost threefold in a course of 5 years. Also, this project helped us to seeing the success of this. We duplicated this. And we right now have two teams going to two different areas every day. Also, we want to replicate this model across all our hospital branches so that we could cover the entire states of Tamil Nadu, Kerala, with adjoining parts of Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh. Also, at this time, we have also submitted a proposal to the National Eye Institute, along with a group from headed by Dr. Pete Campbell, on automated reading for ROP, because we do have the database. Thank you.